Praise be Jesus and Mary. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." Others, me and you sisters, we are today also celebrating the memorial of Mother Teresa of Calcutta. In some way, a reflection in the readings we can call connected to her. Why? According to Father J.D., one of the priests in the Archdiocese of Manila, in our readings today, especially in the first reading, we see one of the characteristics of God. And what is that? Mystery. No? Mysterio, sabi nga. No? And as St. Paul said in the first reading, no? If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him be a fool so as to become wise. You know, this is interesting, and really we have to ponder these words. Why? Because many of us, especially those who have attained a high degree of education, we think that we already know all things. No? Diba? Madalas sabi, alam ko na yan. No? Narinig ko na yan. No? Tapos na ako dyan. No? See? And in the remember, the more you said you know, the more you do not know. No? And for God, for St. Paul and our Lord, no? Being wise does not mean you know everything. The beauty of it is that for God, for the saint, being wise means being aware that you do not know everything. That is what being wise means. Because the more you are aware that you do not know everything, that what you learn is only part of what you have to learn, no? Then you can be teachable. I remember one beautiful, one beautiful videos in the TikTok recently. No? He said, sabi doon, good and bad people teaches us. No? Good people teaches us to love, to be cared, no? To respect. Bad people teaches us to be patient, to forgive, and to understand. So, sabi niya din, so learn from them. No? Be teachable. That is true. See, if we are like child, just like what Jesus said, no? Become like a child. It means that like a child, no? We must always learn. No? We do not stop learning. No? And every day, we learn many things. If we only open our eyes, wag lang yung katulad dun sa mga charismatic, no? Alam niyo yun. Sabi ng pastor, brothers and sisters, no? Ipikit nyo ang inyong mga mata at ating kantahin, open our eyes, O Lord. We want to see Jesus. No? Bakit pinapikit mo, tapos kakantahin mo, open our eyes, no? See? And, you know, as I have said, no, in the gospel today, it is connected. Simon Peter, who is a fisherman, no, how many years he lived in the sea? Saint Simon Peter, no? Saint Peter. No? But when Jesus said, "Go, lower the nets," did Peter said, "Oy, huwag kang makialam, hindi ka naman mangingisda. No? Nag-preach ka nga lang dyan, ang yabang-yabang mo. No? Utusan mo pa kaming i-ano yung lambat? Are you commanding us?" Did Peter do that? Did Peter said that? No. On the contrary, Peter knew that he has to learn on that moment. No? And when Jesus said, "Go, put your nets," no? He only presented the occasion, no? Ang nangyari. And then said, "Okay, Lord, because you commanded, we will do it." And what happened? Miracles happened. No? Nangyari yung milagro. No? Lahat ng mga isda, siguro sa buong Galilee, no? Nagtipon-tipon, nag-meeting. Doon tayo sa barko ni Peter. No? And what happened? A great catch of fish. And at the end, as I have read to you, no, the very beautiful word of Saint Peter: "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." See, acknowledging his ignorance, acknowledging who he really is in front of Jesus. See, and you know, that is also what the life of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, no. He became a saint because he is simple. She is simple and she is humble. No? He never, Mother Teresa, she never talked about her accomplishment. No. He always talked about her poor. No? The needs of the poor. But never you heard on Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta that he boast or speak of the greatness of his accomplishment. Now, no? And when Saint John Paul II, I think, or Pope Paul VI, Saint Pope Paul VI, give him a limousine, if I'm not mistaken, no? What did she do? No? She said, "Holy Father, what will I do with this now? So I will just sell it so that I may be able to feed the poor." See? And one time, no, with his simplicity and humility, no, a woman, a rich woman from England, if I'm not mistaken, no, saw him, no, washing the puss, no, yung nana, sa sugat ng isang kitong, you know, it's really, you know, yung babae almost want to vomit, no? And he said, "Mother, no, if you give me even $1 million or pounds, I will not do it, what you are doing right now." And Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta looked at her, no? And she said, "Even I, my daughter, I will not do it for $100 million. But you know," he said, "I'm doing it because of God, because of Jesus." No? And see, because of that, an atheist, yung mga hindi naniniwala sa Diyos, was converted just by looking at her. Why? Because of her simplicity, because of her humility, because she knows that God is a mysterious person, but God wants to teach us every day that what we know is only, sabi nga, katiting lang, no, of what God is. So even, no, here we can apply it, no, thanks, napakaganda ng reflection ni Father kanina, no, we can apply this character of mystery with God to all the liturgy, especially, no? People may think, no, the liturgy must be with the people. Of course, I agree with that. They must participate. But sometimes the problem with the liturgy today, it takes out the mystery. No? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! No? Tapos, ano na, no? Kahit sa, no? Tinining! Tinining! That's very, very noisy. No? Noise! Remember, noise takes out the mystery in the liturgy. Minsan, ingay na lang. Wala na yung true meaning. That's why Pope Benedict the 16 and even Pope Francis, no? They underline, no, the silence during the Mass. No? Yung katahimikan, no? A moment of silence, no? Kung natapos na yung, for example, sa communion Mass, kung natapos na yung kanta, no? Stop there. Make the people be in silent, no? Reflecting on the Eucharist they receive. Di ba? Hindi naman obligatory na dagdagan mo pa ng another song, no? Habang naglilinis pa yung pare. That's the time that you may be able to reflect of what Jesus has, no? For you, that you receive Him in the Holy Communion. Silence preserves mystery in the liturgy. Ayun ang importante. And we, sad to say, yun ang nawawala sa atin ngayon. Even in the churches, even in the community, no? Pag wala yung superior, doon nagchichismisan, pag nandiyan yung superior, pagdating sa refectory, tahimik, no? See? What kind of silence is that? Huh? And, no? Masyado nang maingay, no? You know, noise, I repeat, no? Take away the mystery. And Mother Teresa of Calcutta, no? Although she is a very, very active apostolic woman, she made time for prayer and adoration. No? Ito yung minsan, no, nawawala sa atin, no? Pati na sa mga kumbento, no? Kala natin, project dito, project doon, misa dito, misa doon. Of course, there's nothing wrong with that. But sometimes, it exhausts us. At the point that during prayer, during liturgy, during rosary, tulog yun. No? See? And we will say, oh, anyway, what I do is for God. Yes. But if you have no time for God, would you think that God will be pleased? Kahit makapagpatayo ka pa dyan ng magandang basilika o katedral, o naman yan. No? But if you have no mystery of God in you, in your prayer life, in your Mass, ingat ka. No? The devil might use it. Pwedeng gamitin ang demonyo yun for your own perdition. No? Maraming ganyan. No? Kaya nga, we must not put too much emphasis, no, on doing more and putting God less. No? Even Mother Teresa, no, the sisters told her, no, Mother, we have many apostolate. We should concentrate on our poor, on serving them, no? And shorten our prayer time. And what did Mother Teresa said? She looked at the sister, no, and said, "No, sister, you're wrong. No? The more we have the apostolate, the more we must spend time with Jesus. See? On the contrary, we have to enlarge our prayer time in the community because we need God to serve God. We need God to serve God. Yun ang problema sa atin. We thought that apostolate is all. No. Remember, apostolate is only a fruit. What kind of fruit is that if the tree withers? Kung ang puno ay patay na, kung ang puno wala ng nutrition, anong klaseng bunga ang makukuha mo? Wala. No? Durian? Durian, marang, ano ba yan? No? Pagsira na yung tree, it will not bear a good fruit. No matter how good is the fruit is, but if the tree withers and is not nourished, it will be rotten. Ganun din sa atin. That's why we have to really imitate Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Enter, enter into the mystery of God. And that is what we do. Every time we pray, every time we have the liturgy of the hours, every time we have the Mass, God is inviting us to enter into His mystery. No? And those who do not enter yet, see, they are distracted. Sabi ko nga, sa mga meme, Uy, ay ko sa kanila, Uy, kamong mga meme, pati yung mga YFI, pag nag-attend kayo ng misa, huwag kayong upo sa hulihan. Kasi lahat ng mga tao, lalo na yung mga hindi nagsisimba pag, saan sila madalas? Doon sa hulihan. No? Sabi ko, no, give them a good example. Because when you are seated at the back, ang makikita mo yung dumadaan, yung dumating. So your attention wala sa misa. How can you appreciate the Mass, the mystery of the Mass? Kung lahat tinitingnan mo, ay si sister oh, kagahapon na, nagkita kami, ay si brother oh. See? But if you are in front, in front of the first pew, total, kung wala namang mga ano doon, wala namang nakalagay na reserve, you can go there. So that your attention will be at the Mass, at the priest. Yun yung sakit. Sabihin ko na sa inyo, total, sakit na mga friars, sakit na mga sisters, sakit na mga, And you know, we as religious should be the first to give good example. And yet, we are the bad examples. Kaya, nakikita tayo, ginagaya tayo ng ibang tao. Ay, nandun si Fra, laki-laki ng simbahan. Ayan. Laki-laki ng simbahan. Asan si Fra? Asan si sister? Ayun, nasa dulo. Anong ginagawa sa dulo? How can we help the people of God reflect on the mystery? Kitang religious, including myself, let us be in the first row. So that what we are celebrating, we will be able to enter into the mystery of the Mass, the liturgy. Paano kasi? Bakit yung iba nasa likod? Alam nyo kung isa pang nabisto ko, because normal naman, Kala siguro nila hindi alam, Kaya nasa dulo, ano nyo kung bakit? Habang nagpipreach yung pare o anong hawak? Cellphone. Cellphone. Ayun, sa cellphone, habang nag-aano yung misa. Ay, sino kaya nag-message na sa akin? Sino kaya yung so, see, you do not, sabi nga, sa, di ba sa eskwela, physically present, mentally absent. So, ganun. No? And I don't know. Malalaman natin, no? Kita mo, sinabi ko yan doon sa ano, but still, no? Many prepared to sit at the back. No? Nahihiya? No. And I don't think so. No? Tapos sa angal, oh, wala naman ako naintindihan sa misa. Hindi ka man naintindihan sinabi ni Father. Hindi ka man naintindihan yung ano. Paano mo maintindihan? Nandun ka sa dulo. Paano ka makikinig kung nandun ka? See? Brothers and sisters, no? I include myself, that's why I said brothers and sisters, no? We have to really, no? Put emphasis that God is a mystery, no? And does that mean that we do not be able to understand Him? No. It only means that if God is mysterious, we should humble ourselves and ask His love and grace to help us, to humble us, to be simple, like Mother Teresa of Calcutta, so that we may be able to help many, many souls and many, many poor person, not only meant, not only poor materially, but poor spiritually and morally. Praise be Jesus and Mary.